Hello and welcome to my channel. It's springtime, in case you live under a rock and hadn't noticed yet. Or live in somewhere where it's like autumn now. Anyway, if you live somewhere where it's springtime. Hello, obviousness. So I thought it'd be a fun idea to do a look that's, well, basically I wanted to do something that's nice, you know, that just looks fun if you're going somewhere. But it's also very lightweight, so, you know, in the sun and all, you won't really feel like you're wearing a lot of makeup. You won't feel like cake face. So yeah, that's the idea for today. Of course, it can greatly differ per person how much concealer you're using. I gotta admit, I typically use quite a lot. But that's all up to your own personal preference, of course. Now, I'm already moving on to eyebrows because I'm not gonna use powder. Lately, I've really been into not doing powder when I want to look really natural. Just because I feel when you're going to use... Like, you know, when you use foundation and powder, you're really gonna end up having to do like contour and blush quite heavily to sort of balance the mattness of the face. You know, and it's just more obvious that you're wearing makeup if you also powder it off. Whereas if you don't powder it, it just looks a lot more natural. If you don't want to be too oily during the day, you can always just use a bit of blotting paper. When you try to talk faster than you think, try to use a little bit of blotting paper to get the oiliness off. And if you get creases under your eyes, you can always just blend it a little bit again. That's a plus when you don't apply powder. You can just easily re-blend your makeup. So yeah, and just the entire result is a lot more natural. Same for the brows, I'm just keeping them really, really natural. But yeah, you can just do your brows however you prefer to do them, because typically everyone has their own little way in which they prefer to do their eyebrows. Then some brow gel. This particular one actually has the power to make my eyebrows stay in place all day despite bangs and work and life. It's Control Freak by Nyx, really recommend it. Everything I've used, by the way, will be listed below the video in the description as always. And as always, you don't need to use the exact same products as I'm using. And then, for blush, I'm actually going to use a lipstick. This is, well, more of a lip balm by Yves Rocher. But I'm just putting this on and then I'm going to blend it out with my fingers. And do make sure your hands are clean, because hygiene and all, you probably don't want to give yourself zits. Talking about hygiene might be a little bit of a hypocrite thing, I guess, though, because I am smearing a lipstick that also uses lipstick directly on my face from the actual pencil. But let's ignore that. I mean, admittedly, whenever I do a completely natural look, I oftentimes just actually use that one as a lipstick as well, but today I have other plans. But anyway, I'm just applying a cream stick highlighter, really, by Yves Rocher. It's sort of a pale, glowy, gold shade. Nothing too obvious, just something that's just nice and glowy. Now, for the eyes, I'm using Alice Faas mostly, just because her cream products are just really, really good. But anyways, yeah, whatever you use in terms of cream products, I always would advise you to put it on a brush a little bit and then immediately apply it while blending, basically. Because especially with really good quality products, you know, you might just apply it and it will be really pigmented and you'll suddenly have a really dark smoky eye even though you're trying to go for something more natural. Yes, it happened to me a lot. So yeah, I always prefer to put it on this way. And my idea is basically to go for sort of a green tinted... Well, I like the look I did like a couple of weeks ago, I think. The 80s look with like a nice dark crease and then a pale eyelid. That's basically what I'm gonna go for. What you can also do is apply your brow bone highlight. What you can also do to blend it a little bit more is to apply a pale eye pencil like I did now beneath your eyebrow and just blend it downwards a little. Just to have a cream brow bone highlight. That's not necessarily shimmery. I personally don't like to use shimmer there because I have oily skin and it just looks really greasy on me. Then the shimmer for the eyelids. I was gonna say that it looks like a liquid green. And then I realized that liquid green just sort of makes me remember stuff like, I don't know, goose poop and vomit. So yeah, let's not compare it to green liquid things. Instead, it just looks like, I don't know, like green molten metal It's really pretty. Then I'm also going to apply some eyeliner with the dark green color. And it's on there, and it's actually quite even. I like how it looks because it's, you know, like it's subtle, but it is there. It does give it a more angular shape to the eyeballs without making it too much for a natural look. But yeah, I'm just applying now my inner corner highlight with a little tiny bit of a Catrice liquid metal. And this is literally a liquid metal, so if you apply too much of it, it's just going to be metallic. And I don't want it to be metallic today, I just want it to be a nice glow. What does help is that I, obviously, that was the entire point, didn't powder beneath it. So it does blend really nicely now. Okay, I don't know if you can hear it, but it's raining really hard outside. It's like, okay, I tried to do a springtime look and the weather is like, screw you. Not springtime weather at all. More like autumn, but anyway, let's ignore that and just hope that, you know, awful weather now means that we'll have lovely weather in summer. A person can hope. But yeah, anyway, back to the makeup. I'm just gonna apply the dark green shade a little bit. Like I said, a little bit. Beneath my lower lashes, just to darken it up a little bit underneath there to really finish that nice eye shape we got going on. Then we're gonna use the eye pencil that I also used as a brow bone highlight as an actual eye pencil. Now, obviously, I don't want to make a big hassle with falsies when I'm just trying to look relatively natural. So instead, I'm curling my lashes and then I'm gonna go for a mascara. Now, as usually, if I want to go for huge, big, natural lashes, I go for Word High by NYX. However, I have been noticing that it doesn't really keep the curl in my lashes that much. So instead, I'm just going to go with the brand I've been using a lot on my eyeball today. And go for the Alice Faas mascara. Okay, it's on there. I gotta say, I'm pleasantly surprised. Let's hope my camera will focus. Thank you, camera. Yes, in the Dutch version of the video, I had to really, really force the camera to focus. It was frustrating. Anyway, what I was trying to show you, the lashes, I hope you can tell, are really nice like this. They're not clumpy at all. They're really just a nice shape. I do hope they're gonna keep curly. If you wanna know if it keeps curly, is it even proper English? I don't know. If you want to know if my eyelashes remain curly throughout the day with this mascara, you can always ask me in the comments below, because I'm definitely going to forget to put it in this video. but yeah, it's really, really pretty for now. So yeah, so far so good. All that's left to do is the lips, and after that we're done. For set lips, I'm going to go for a basically a sort of pale orangey red shade. You could always go for a nude shade, of course, if that's what you prefer, you know. Basically, it's up to your own personal preference. A nude would make it a bit more... I don't know, I guess a nude would make it more casual and a red will make it more fancy. So yeah, just decide what vibe you're going for. And that leaves us with the final results. Yeah, so this is basically just really what I was going for. Like a soft, fun, sort of more glam vintagey type, I guess. Yeah. It's a springtime look, but it's lightweight and casual enough that I can even wear it to work. So that's good. Although for work, I would probably wear it with a nude lipstick, come to think of it. We'll see. I need to work this afternoon, so I'll see what I'll wear. But yeah, anyways, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. One last advice in terms of makeup, if you are gonna wear this outside and it's sunny, I do recommend always wearing sunscreen. This one is Garnier Ambre Solaire, it's a spray. I don't think you're actually supposed to spray this directly on the face. I do it anyway, but you gotta make your own choices whether or not you want to risk it. Yeah, point is, I always like sunscreen sprays because you can just spray them over makeup like some form of SPF setting spray without risking smearing the makeup. So yeah, I really love spray sunscreens. So yeah, that was really all I had to say for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!